We know that 100 paise is equal to 100 paise is equal to rupees 1. This we know. Rupees 1 is equal to 100 paise. So suppose now I want to see 1 paise means how much rupees. See, 1 paise is equal to how much rupees. So what I am doing for this, for 1 I am dividing by 100. Okay, so I want to convert this paise into rupees. For that I will divide by 100. Okay, so 1 upon 100. Now 1 upon 100. Now see, this division we have learned. When we divide by 10, 100, 1000, we have to shift the decimal point. Okay, so now here 2 zeros are there. So shift the decimal point before 2 digits. Now here 1 we have to write. Here only 1 digit is there. So here we have to give 1, 0. Okay, so 1, 2. 2 digits. Before 2 digits, from right towards left, we have to give the decimal point. So what we got? 0.01 rupees. Okay, 1 paise means rupees 0.01. Okay, 1 paise is equal to rupees 0.01. So here for measure of money means in this, what we did, we use the decimal point. Okay, means we are using the decimal in daily life. Okay, measure of mass. See, 1000 gram is equal to 1 kilogram. This you know already, 1 kg is 1000 gram. Now suppose 1 gram is how much kilogram? For that we need to use the decimal point. See here, 1 gram is equal to how much kg? So for 1, what we are doing? We are dividing by this 1000. Okay? We are dividing by this 1000. Okay? So we will get kg. Now see how many number of zeros are here? 3. So before 3 digit, we shift the decimal point. So this 1 right here. Okay, 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. Before 3 digit, give the decimal point. So what we will get? 0.001 kg. Okay, so 1 gram is 0.001 kg. So here also, for measurement of mass also we are using the decimal point. Okay, this here also we are using. Now measure of length. Now measure of length. See, by which number we have to divide it, we will not understand. What we are using? We are using the triangle that already I have explained you. Okay, now just for use of decimals in money, mass and length. For that I am explaining this. Okay, now see. 10 mm is equal to 1 centimeter. 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. See, if you will take your scale. See now on this it is marked with a black by showing on the board. See, from 0 to 1. From 0 to 1. In between 0 to 1. See, these are the small 10 divisions. So, 0 to first small division, that is 1 mm distance. Okay? 1 mm. So, 0 to 1. There are small 10 divisions. Okay? So, 10 mm is equal to 1 centimeter. Okay? 10 mm is equal to 1 centimeter. So, 1 mm is equal to how much centimeter? 1 mm is equal to how much centimeter? So, for that what I will do? 1 upon 10. 1 divided by 10. So, what I will get the answer here? 0.1 centimeter. 1 mm is equal to how much centimeter? So, 1 mm is equal to 1 upon 10. See, you can use the triangle also for this. Showing 1 mm is equal to how much? Centimeter. Okay, so 1 mm. Here mm, and I want to convert into centimeter, means I am coming one step down. So what I have to do? 1/10. 1/10 means what it will come? See, 10. So give before one digit decimal point. So 0.1 centimeter. Okay, so what we got here? 0.1 centimeter. Now 10 mm is equal to 1 centimeter. Now 100 centimeter. Suppose 100 centimeter is equal to 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter, that we know. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. Okay, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Now suppose I want to ask you, 1 centimeter is equal to how much meter? I want to find 1 centimeter is equal to how much meter. Now where is centimeter? Centimeter is here. And where is meter? Meter is here. So how many steps I will come down? 2 steps down. So 2 steps down means divide by 100. So what we will get? See, 2 zeros are here. So shift the decimal point before 2 digits. Okay. So 0.01 meter. Okay. So 1 centimeter means 0.01 meter. Means from this what I want to explain you, we are using the decimal in measurement of length also. Okay, so 1 centimeter is equal to 0.01 meter. Now after that, 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer, or we can say 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. See, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So now if I want to find 1 meter is equal to how much kilometer? 1 meter is equal to how much kilometer? So for that what we have to do? 1 meter is equal to how much kilometer? See, we have to divide by 1000. Okay, but still I will show you. 1 meter, where is meter? Meter is here. And I want to convert into kilometer. See, kilo, where is kilo? Kilometer is here. So 1, 2, 3. 3 steps down. See here. I will show you again. Down. Okay, so 3 steps down. So for 1 we have to divide by 1000. See, for 1 we have to divide by 1000. So what will you get? 1, 2, 3. 3 zeros. So shift the decimal point 3 digit before. 1, 2, 3. So what we will get? 0.001 kilometer. See, 1 meter is equal to 0.001 kilometer. See, so what we are doing here? Measure in measurement of length also. What we are using? We are using decimal point. Okay, we are using here decimal point. See, here I have not shown the division, here I have written direct answer, but expression I have explained here. Okay. Let's solve question number 7. Kripa Shankar bought 2 meter 60 centimeter cloth for his kurta and 1 meter 75 centimeter cloth for his pajama. Find the total length of cloth bought by him in meters. What it is as? Find the total length of cloth. See, what it is as? Total length of cloth means for kurta, how much cloth is given? 2 meter 60 centimeter, and for pajama 1 meter 75 centimeter. Then how find the total length of cloth bought by him means how much cloth he bought. Okay, so total length it is as, means what we have to do? We have to add. Now it is given in meter and centimeter. So simply we can write directly here meter and centimeter. How much it is bought for the kurta? 2 meter 60 centimeter. So 2 meter 60 centimeter. Okay, and for his kurta, and 1 meter 75 centimeter cloth for his pajama. Okay, so for pajama how much he brought? 1 meter 75 centimeter. Now what we are going to do? We are going to add. What we have to find? Total length of cloth. What is the total length of cloth? So we can add. Okay, so 0 plus 5, 5. 6 plus 7, 13, 1 is carry, 1 plus 2, 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So what we got answer? 4 meter, 35 centimeter. So find the total length of cloth bought by him in meters, 4 meter, 35 centimeter, or we can write 4.35 meter. Okay, so 4 meter, 35 centimeter answer we got. And find the total length of cloth bought by him in meters, 4.35 meter. Okay, so only we can write 4 meter, 35 centimeter. Let's solve question number 8. A 20 meter length of rope is cut into 4 pieces. Okay, suppose now this is the length of 20 meter. Suppose this is the length of 20 meter. 20 meter. This total length is 20 meter. Okay, this from here to here. It is 20 meter. Okay, total this length is 20 meter. Of rope is cut into 4 pieces. This rope is cut into 4 pieces. Have the lengths. Now see here. 3 of the pieces have length. From that 3 pieces have length. Now suppose this length is 5.62 meter. It is cut. See from here to here. This distance is 5.62 meter. Okay. Then 8.05 meter. From here to here. Suppose this distance is 8.05 meter. Okay. This distance is 8.05 meter. And 2.6 meter. Now this much distance is suppose 2.6 meter. It is just we have to consider to understand it. So see, for 20 meter length of rope, this rope is 20 meter. This from here to here distance is 20 meter. Just we have to consider this distance is 20 meter. Okay, of rope is cut into 4 pieces. This is cut into 4 pieces. Okay, 3 of the pieces are. Now first piece length is how much? It is given 5.62 meter. Okay, this much length is 5.62. Then 8.05 meter and third one is 2.6 meter. So find the length of the fourth piece. Now this is suppose fourth piece and what is the length of this piece? See this length, how much is the length of this piece? See how much is the length of this piece? So we don't know the length of this piece, so we have to consider here x. Okay, now what we are going to do? We know the total length of rope. Okay, we know the total length of rope, it is 20. This total length is 20. So what we can do? We can add this 3. We can add this 3. See, 5.62. What we do? See, this is total length of rope. Okay, and from that, these are the 3 pieces. This is the length of 3 pieces, and we have to find the length of 4th piece. Okay, what it is given? Find the length of the 4th piece. How much is the length of this 4th piece? And total length, we know how much it is. Total length 20 meter. It is given. Total we know. Only we don't know this much. So what we can do? 5.62 meter plus 8.05 meter plus 2.6. Okay, 6. Now here places bracket, so right here 0 meter. Okay, so this we will add because see this and this we know. Okay, and total length is given 20 meter. So this we will add. Okay, so 5 plus 2, 7. 6 plus 6, 12. 1 is carry. 2 plus 8, 10. 10 plus 5, 15. 15 plus 1, 16. So 16.27 meter. It is given the length of 3 pieces, first, second, and third. These 3 pieces 3.27 meter. Okay. Why 20? Because total length how much it is given? 20. So here see, we have to write decimal point here at 0, 0. Okay. So 20 meter it is given. So what we need is see, this is total length of row. Okay, how much it is given? This total distance is 20, and three pieces length is given. See, this is first, second, and third. So these, if we will subtract, these if we will cut from 20, then we'll get remaining length of piece. Okay, then we'll get the remaining length of piece. So what we'll do from 20, we'll subtract this addition. Okay, so what we got total of these three, 16.27 meter, and total length of rope is 20 meter. So from that this three length, from that these three pieces length will subtract, then we get the length of four piece. Okay, so 0 minus 7 is possible, not possible, so take borrow, you cannot give, so take borrow from me, cannot give, take borrow from me. Okay, so here remain one, now you can borrow. Yes, so here remain 9. Can borrow? So here remain 9. Okay, so now 10 minus 7, 3, 9 minus 2, 7. Decimal point give the amount, decimal point 9.9 minus 6, 3, 1 minus 1, 0. So what we got? 3.73. So what it is asked? Find the length of the fourth piece. The length of fourth piece is, what you will write here, the length of fourth piece is 3.73.